Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Friday, the end of a very, very focused week. I am leading a big workshop on Sunday. I am teaching 200 girls how to journal. And so my energy has really been channeled into that, along with resting and tending to my energy because I've been so sick. So yesterday, I am so thankful to my sister Shannon and my husband Justin, who so kindly played the role of 12-year-old girls as I presented my workshop to them. They did a very good job at asking appropriate questions, showing the right level of excitement or confusion, and it was really, really fun and good for me to feel grounded in what I'm going to share. And this is one of the things I think is really important if you're doing a workshop, and I've shared this with you before, or if you're speaking to people, to practice before you go, and especially to do so out loud. Feel your way through and notice what ran smoothly like a river and where you got stopped and where you got stuck in. That experience of turning it into something closer, a closer approximation of what you'll be doing live, really, really helps. And that's something I learned from theater. Now, as I was getting ready for this workshop, I went back and looked at all of my old journals. Here is my very, very first journal. And see, you can see the sensitive girl written all over even the cover, and it's really small. And honestly, my first three journals are mostly filled with poetry. It just poured out of my heart and onto the page. And then I have about a million of these, most with really fabulous covers. There was this period of time that this art store called, there's a blue jay at my window. I think maybe at this time of year, it's spring enough for all the birds to be around, but the trees don't have leaves yet, so I can see them all. It's very exciting. So there was this store in Toronto called Gortzman's on Spadina, and they used to have these with phenomenal covers. So I've got like this green sparkly one that looks like, it's so sparkly, it looks like diner chairs. Do you know what I mean? I've got ones that are plush, crushed purple velvet. I've got one that's a leopard print, and they were so beautiful, and I can't find them anymore, and that makes me sad. But I love them, and honestly, I spent many, many years where my journal was, this must be the precursor to dream boards, was gluing in either things that I attended, like there are some plays I went to, there's a picture of my mom, things I attended, like, oh, this was amazing. We went to see, when Lord of the Rings came out, we went to see this exhibit at Casa Loma, celebrating my birthday from my sister Susie and her husband Reg. I mostly kept things like that in it, or, you know, pictures that inspired me. And so I'm still doing those things in various forms. Years ago, one of my favorite things I ever did on my blog was run a book club. And it's something I think about doing again often. It was called The Next Chapter. And we worked through many books. And one of the ones that was the biggest hit was Carrie Smith's Wreck This Journal. And here is mine. Like, I have glued in feathers, as you can see. I've cut holes in the cover. I have things stuck to it. This was my very first business card. Those of you who watched my Stella story will recognize Stella. And it is filled stuff I dripped, a page I sewed. This was to document time passing. I collected all the transfers that I used when traveling on the bus or the subway. And it was fascinating to see what people found the easiest or the hardest to do. And the hardest thing most people found was breaking the binding. That was like, what? And one woman decided to break the binding on a video and ended up literally accidentally tearing the book in two. It was hilarious. So breaking the binding was the hardest for most people, but for me, what I found the hardest was spilling food in it. Ah, it still kind of freaks me out that I did that somewhere in here. So those are some of the journals that I've kept. My mind has been so fully immersed in journaling. Today, I'll be getting the newsletter to go out to those of you who are members of the studio on Sunday, and I hope that's all of you. And what I'm thinking I'm going to share is some of the top tips that have come up that everyone wants to make sure the girls know. I thought that would be useful for all of us to know too. So that's where I'm thinking of going, and that's what I'm going to work on today. Wish me luck on Sunday. If you have a 10 to 12 year old girl in your vicinity, she's your neighbor, she's your niece, she's your friend's daughter, she's your daughter, think about whether journaling might be something that she would enjoy too. Maybe you can bring the magic of journaling to a girl in this world. Have a great weekend. I will look so forward to sharing all of the details with you on Monday.